bad news for Barack Obama's legacy, turns out he's violating federal law. Former President Barack Obama did much to damage the United States. He doubled the national debt, more than every other president combined. His irresponsible rhetoric led to greater racial tensions and violence. And, who can forget about Obamacare, a problem that still haunts us? Now, we are learning that the monument that will celebrate his legacy will harm Americans even more. As it turns out, he's violating federal law, and we're not at all surprised. The Obama presidency was all about prestige. He seemed to only care about how he could benefit from being president. He hobnobbed with celebrities at the White House and threw lavish galas. All the while, he pushed social justice through the federal government. He abused executive authority. And, he turned Americans against each other. It comes as no surprise that his library will be a monument to his ego. Already, there's been controversy about the presidential library. The cost shocked more than a few people. Many were curious why it would lack a physical archive of his administration's documents. Even the design was ugly and unappealing. Now, we are learning that the building might be violating federal laws. The proposed site is on protected land. Building on it would destroy historically significant locations. But, who cares, right? This is for Obama after all. Preservationist groups are warning that the planned Barack Obama Center in Chicago may violate federal laws against destroying sites placed on the National Register of Historic Places. The Obama Center is currently planned to spread out over sections of three sites with history stretching back to 1869, according to the Chicago Sun-Times. The portion of Jackson Park that Obama intends to disrupt with his massive new project includes the area where the World's Columbian Exposition was staged in Jackson Park and the Midway in 1893. Created by famed architect Daniel Burnham, the man who planned New York's Central Park, the Midway was placed on the Historic Site Registry in 1972. Obama's center is also expected to disrupt a portion of Frederick Law Olmsted's Washington Park, a site that was added to the registry in 2004. Finally, the Obama plan will also require the closure of Cornell Drive, a roadway that is an integral part of the park system. Source: Breitbart. Wow. His park will damage not one, but three significant parts of this park system. It begs the question, why didn't Obama's people know about this ahead of time? Shouldn't they have done their due diligence to ensure they weren't violating protected land? Remember when liberals pitched a fit over President Donald Trump returning protected land back to citizens? Remember when Obama prevented development on land that was protected by the government? I guess that only matters when you're trying to destroy private industry. When you're building a monument to Obama's ego, history doesn't matter. Liberals want to protect land that is not being used, for environmental reasons. But, land that preserves our history, value, and traditions? Who cares? Obama wants to build an ugly library on the land. So, what if it destroys the accomplishments of much better men? The need to fully recognize the unity of the South Parks is now brought into greater relief by the current proposal to impose a parking garage at the eastern terminus and hinge point of the Midway Plaisance, effectively placing a further barrier to the connection that Olmsted and Vaux first envisioned, the group's president, Charles Birnbaum, wrote in a recent letter to the federal government. Birnbaum added that Olmsted's design was intended to lead visitors on a choreographed journey through passages of landscape scenery. Neither the location nor the disposition of the roads were accidental. He noted that the Obama Center would erase that journey. The preservationist also noted that the huge tower planned for the center itself would also destroy the historic sites. Source: Breitbart. This park was carefully designed by master craftsmen. They wanted visitors to have a special experience when they walked those grounds. It was all deliberately planned and envisioned. Obama's library tramples all over that vision. Pretty appropriate, given how liberals operate. The left regularly seeks to destroy our history and traditions. They never think about the consequences of their reckless policies or actions. Only in hindsight do we realize how destructive they've been. Such is the case with this library. Make no mistake, this will be a fight. The planners will not want to move the library, after all this time. But will the historical societies be able to win? Or will they be shouted down by rabid Obama supporters?